students, welcome to the class on editorial decode. And in this class, I will be decoding the elephant at the peace table written by Aisha Siddiqua. Now, from examination point of view, this will help you in chemistry's mains examination paper 2. Plus, this is important for political science optional students. Now, what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how Pakistan is not a singular nation. This editorial is about how India needs to deal parallelly with the military that is present in Pakistan if it wants to solve the intricate problem of Kashmir. This editorial is also about how the forces of military, the forces of army are more important in Pakistan. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand the importance of military in Pakistan. Now, as far as military in Pakistan is concerned, it has toppled the democratic system at least 3 times since Pakistan has got its independence. So, we have seen the democracy getting derailed in Pakistan. So this is the importance of military in Pakistan. So it is upon military to decide about how long it wants the sustenance of democracy in Pakistan. Now another question that comes to mind of why military is so important in Pakistan. What is the reason behind it? Now, in order to know about the reasons of importance in Pakistan, we need to understand the ideology of Islam. We need to understand how the Muslim countries actually work. Now, when you look at this concept of democracy and what Islam propagates and what does the system of governance that is prevalent in the Muslim countries stand for, we find that democracy is generally incompatible with the forces that are generally prevalent in the Muslim nations. So, ideologically, the Muslim world is more inclined to authoritarian setups. Muslim world is more inclined to military kind of setup, and this is the reason why Pakistan has a very fragile kind of network with respect to democracy. This is the reason why the forces which strengthen this concept of democracy are not prevalent in Pakistan. This is the reason why Pakistan has not been able to entrench democracy the way it should have been able to do it till now. Now, this is the reason, ideological reason, why military is strong. Then we have got another reason of why military is strong in Pakistan, and that reason relates to the battle between capitalism and communism. Now Pakistan, it had aligned with capitalism, and because it had aligned with capitalism and it wanted to accrue some sort of benefits from this capitalist world in order to solve the intricate problem of Kashmir. So it had offered its army to the NATO group. Because it had offered this army has become in itself an institution which has increased the legitimacy of Pakistan. Now this is the second reason. The third reason has to do with the concept of aid. Now, Pakistan has been receiving a lot of aid and funding, and this aid and funding was pumped in Pakistan to strengthen its military so that it can support their capitalist lords in fighting against the specter that they used to call it as, actually. To fight against the specter of communism. So this is the third reason why military is so strong. Now another reason why military is so strong in Pakistan. For that we need to unearth India's independence movement. Like India had certain political leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru, like we had Mahatma Gandhi, we had Gopal Krishna Gokhale, we have actually a huge resource of iconography in India which has helped Indianness to develop. Now this Indianness actually stands for democracy. This Indianness stands for the rights of the people, because for about 200 years we were fighting against the colonial forces. 200 years we were shouting for human rights. 200 years we were shouting against the forces that were crippling the rights of the people. Peasants were shouting. Artisans were shouting. Women's section was shouting. Student section was shouting. The servicemen were shouting. So this shout of 200 years, it had created a kind of an imprint in the mind of the people about the importance of human rights and democracy. But when it comes to the iconography of Pakistan, the Pakistan-ness had always meant that they wanted to match with the Hindu counterparts. Pakistan-ness had always stood for communalism. Pakistan-ness had always stood for protecting the religion. Pakistan-ness was guided by more fundamentalist and orthodox sections. So the kind of the iconography that the Pakistan has, that iconography has not been able to create a kind of a system which could help to sustain democracy. But this thing is very much available in India. And this is the reason why we have a very strong parallel authority structure of army in India versus the political structure. And India will never ever be giving away the space to military and army. But in Pakistan, the Pakistan-ness is very fragile. Pakistan-ness is a kind of a fluke idea. And because of that, military has gained a lot of importance over there. Now when it comes to this diplomatic talks, so it becomes very important for India to engage the military of Pakistan. But how it should be engaging military of Pakistan in order to solve these diplomatic roles that we are going against each other, it is a tough thing to predict. It is a tough thing to tell. So this is all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes and entire Civil Services preparation. In order to avail the information of the classes that I'm offering, please visit our website eiasmentors.com and brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.